ROI, return on investment. This is very important for any business. Whenever person will think to start business, first he will think ROI. What is the ROI in this business? So how it is being calculated? So there is a two factors. One is the investment. So if anyone will start business, then what will be required? First is the investment, and after investment we use to calculate what will be return on investment. So what are the factors, what are the important factors in this to calculate ROI? So basically, if anyone is doing general distribution business like distribution of parts of any automobile companies like three wheeler, four wheeler, two wheeler, so in this what will be required? Investment. So investment is what actually? Basically, if you are looking to become distributor of any company, so first they will ask for the infra. What is infra? Warehouse, initial stocking, market outstanding. So this will become investment actually. You have to purchase or take on rent one warehouse. You have to make payment to the company for the initial stocking. And then once you start business, then your market outstanding also will be there, and it is continuously increasing once your business, once your sales will grow. So these are three factors. Now manpower. To run the business, manpower required. In manpower, you need manager, you need sales executives, you need billing person. So in investment, how much? What value required to start a distribution business? For example, if any area is having business potential 30 lakhs. So for 30 lakhs business, just we are calculating here, for 30 lakhs business, what will be the investment? So 30 lakhs monthly business, how much stock, how much good stock to do the business of 30 lakhs in distribution? At least many of the companies used to say for 2 months stock should be there, many of the companies 3 months also maintaining, and in general 30 days is required actually initially. If you want to grow, if you want to grab the business, initially minimum 30 days stock should be there with you. So for 30 days stock, if you are looking for 30 lakh business, so 30 lakh you have to invest in stock itself. And it's not include GST, it's exclusive GST, because billing is happening on NDP and you are selling on some other value, discount on MRP something. So this is a distributor lending price plus GST, whatever, 18%, 28%. So both GST will be applicable. Some of the items are having 18% GST and some of the items are having 28% GST. So 30 lakhs plus GST, if I am taking average 20%, just 20% I am taking. So it will become 36 lakhs in stock, and almost 18 lakhs will go market outstanding. Slowly it will go to 36 lakhs once regular 36 lakhs business is started. You have to recruit manpower. So you have to invest in infrastructure, almost 15 lakhs, racking system, bins, computer, so all other infrastructure to operate business it is required. So how much it is right now stock? Stock 36 lakhs, and then outstanding 18 lakhs initial stage, and working capital also you should have to place order to the company. At least 10 days ₹3.6 lakhs. So how much it is? 36 plus 3.6, 39.6 plus 18. ₹57.6. So almost you have to invest initially 58 to 60 lakhs. So just we will do calculation on 60 lakhs. So generally in one business you invested 60 lakhs rupees two times of business value assumed, and you are assuming 30 lakhs business. So if 30 lakhs business in any distribution we used to do, so how much it will be in a year? It is 360 lakhs. So revenue generated by businesses 360 lakhs. Now, after 60 lakhs investment, so now calculation is that हाउ मच आर वाई एंड ऑफ द ईयर? आर वाई कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड मंथ वाइज ऑल्सो. वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट ऑल द एक्सपेंसेस मंथ वाइज एंड मंथ वाइज सेल वी हैव टू टेक एंड देन मंथली वी कैन डू. जस्ट आई एम मेकिंग वन कैलकुलेशन हियर फॉर एनुअल आर वाई. सो नाउ वॉट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर? एक्सपेंसेज. रेवन्यू इज दिस 360 lakhs इन अ ईयर. रेंट हाउ मच? इट्स डिपेंड ऑन लोकेशन. इफ इट्स मेट्रो सिटी सो रेंट विल बी हायर साइड एंड आई थिंक 30 lakhs वैल्यू विल नॉट बी सर्वाइवल इनिशियली. बट फॉर फ्यूचर इफ ओनली 30 lakhs बिजनेस इज देयर, सो फॉर फ्यूचर पर्पज इफ ग्रोथ इज देयर देन इट कैन बी प्लान्ड फॉर दैट बिजनेस. रेंट, जस्ट एज्यूमिंग इन वेयर हाउसिंग एरियाज ऑलमोस्ट 30,000 rupees यू कैन गेट मोस्ट ऑफ द प्लेसेस फॉर 30 lakhs वैल्यू. एरिया इज रिक्वायर्ड ऑलमोस्ट 1,500 square feet to 2,000 square feet टू डू द बिजनेस ऑफ 30 lakhs वैल्यू फॉर स्पेयर पार्ट्स. देन मैन पावर ऑलमोस्ट टू ऑपरेट अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन वन मैनेजर, टू सेल्स एग्जीक्यूटिव्स मिनिमम, थ्री पैकर पिकर एंड वन बिलिंग पर्सन. सो ऑलमोस्ट 7 manpower इज नीडेड मिनिमम एंड इफ टेक द सैलरी ऑफ 7 manpower एवरेज 15,000 सो 1.05 lakhs. सो दिस इज 105 1.05 lakhs. Now, incentives. If you are giving target to your executives and planning for the incentive, so you can take 0.5%, 1% of the overall business sales wise. So, if you are doing business of 360 lakhs, so how much will be 1%? This thirty-six lakhs. Three sixty lakhs. So just 3.6 lakhs. Target incentive you have to give. Electricity almost I think 2,000 rupees. Communication, oh, it will be more because of mobiles we have to give. 3K. Audit expenses 5K and office expenses almost 3K. Traveling expenses, this is a per month actually. This is annual, this is a per month. So we can take this almost 13 lakhs and this we can take for 12 months 3.6 lakhs. Incentive, okay. Electricity, it's 24K. Communication, 36K. Audit expenses for the year, it is a 10,000. Office expenses, 36K. So now, traveling expenses almost 30,000 per month. So 3.6 lakhs for the year. Delivery expenses, 4 lakhs for the year. In case of 50 lakh business, 3.6 lakhs, inward, outward, 60K. So now we have to add all these. How much? Rent is 3.6, 13 lakhs. Target incentive is 3.6 lakhs, 24,000. Point 3536, 0.10, 0.36, 3.6, 3.6, 60. So now ₹28.96 lakhs is the expenses for the year. So now if you are doing business 360 lakhs, so majorly in automobile there is a 10% of margin. So 36 lakhs is the margin of profit, 10%. This is a revenue generated, because what is this? This is a revenue generated in a year, and on this 10% is the overall profit. So these are the expenses . So just what we have to do, ₹36 lakhs minus ₹28.96 lakhs. So what is net profit? Net profit is 6.04 lakhs. So now what is the ROI? Return on investment. What we discussed initially, we have invested in the business 60 lakh rupees. And net profit is 6 lakhs. So how much percentage? It is 10% of 60 lakhs. So now this is the ROI. If you are investing 60 lakhs rupees, end of the year, you will be able to get 10% ROI. This is a one sample for business, but most of the distributors on initial stage, they used to get this only. But later on, I seen in my career, many of the distributor started business initially 30 lakhs per month and ROI is 10%, but they grown to 50 lakhs, 70 lakhs, 85 lakhs, 1 crore, 1.5 crore and ROI increases to almost 40 to 45%. So, see, if 1 crore monthly business is there, then annual revenue is 12 crore. So, 40% of 12 crore is the 48 lakhs. Sorry. $4.8 crore. So generally, in 4.8 crore, if we reduce expenses, what is the average expenses? Suppose that for 28 lakh is the annual. So, monthly expenses, odd will be, I can take 25 lakhs because in business, whether small, either big, in both cases, some expenses are fixed. Electricity is fixed. Audit expenses are fixed. Office expenses are fixed. Target incentive fixed. Manpower, small changes are there, but it will not impact that much. Traveling expenses fixed. Almost whatever is on lower business value. So similarly, it will be there. So 2.5 lakhs. Now it means 30 lakhs. So you can take 3 lakhs, 36 lakhs. So just reduce it. Differences may be because if this is a metro city and manpower expenses may be more, like manager salary may increase it to 50,000 to 60,000. So in that case, it will increase. So we can take almost 4 lakh rupees. So 48 lakhs. So now how much is earning? 4.32 lakhs. Now, so if business is growing, definitely investment also will increase, but ROI will increase. But there is a few factors which has to be monitored to increase the ROI in the business. Inventory, turnaround of stock, outstanding. These three things we need to control. You can operate a business with 30 days stock also, 60 days, and 15 days also. And same business can be done. So, if in a month 2 times turnaround is there, so you can increase your ROI. ROI will be go down. In this case, ROI will go down. So, inventory management is the very important part, and we should manage inventory in good way to get good ROI in our business. So this is a only tool. Inventory management is only a tool to increase the ROI. However way you are going to manage your inventory and how good way you are utilizing your money invested in the business. This is the important. Thank you very much.